She's amazing. She deals with my craziness. She's just perfect for me in every way. She's someone I never knew I needed, and she came when I needed her. I love her very much, more than anything. And I can't imagine my life without her, and I can't wait to get it started.
She's strong, she's smart, and every moment of every day, she strives to be that perfect person. And to me, she is. I will love you forever, only you, and I cannot wait to start this beautiful journey with you. Oh my God, you look amazing.
Welcome. Please have a seat.
You're okay. 7 times 7.
What a beautiful night in Savannah. We gather here today in the presence of God, family, and friends to join Jennifer and Tiffany in holy matrimony.
You're okay.
We celebrate the coming together in love of these two incredible women. Let us remember that marriage is a time when growing love is made public. When two people share mutual promises, let us join in our support of them as they offer themselves to each other. And let us celebrate their joy, their love, and their commitment. It is said that the greatest thing, one of the greatest experiences in the whole world is love. Jennifer and Tiffany, into your lives has entered a deep and nurturing love. And you have asked all of us to help you celebrate and affirm that love today. Now, for as long as men and women have walked the earth, there have been some who have expressed their deepest love with someone of the same gender. Fortunately, our society and the laws that govern us have evolved to recognize the validity and beauty of that special way of loving. You have honored us all by inviting us here to witness your commitment to each other in holy union. May your love grow sure and strong and true in the days ahead. Jennifer and Tiffany would like to take a moment to welcome each of you here and thank you for being a part of the happiest day of their life. They'd also like to extend a special thanks to their parents and families. Remembering especially those who are not physically with us today, but whose love and support is and will be felt by them always. Now, if you'll indulge me for just a few minutes, I would like to say a few words about our happy couple before we get too deep into the proceedings here.
Oh, Jesus.
But it's funny, though, as we were driving over this afternoon, I realized we all have a lot in common. None of us really have any idea what I'm going to say. Oh, man. I do realize, though, that I'm in a somewhat precarious position. I'm the only one standing between all of you and a big old piece of wedding cake. I'm also delaying your participation in, well, I think we'd all agree, the preeminent modern wedding phenomenon. The cutting of the cake, maybe? No. The first kiss.
I'm going to go with that one.
The first dance. No.
Here we go.
I'm talking about the electric slide. So I know you're all excited. The DJ's ready. I'll be brief. I did make the mistake of asking my wife, though, what I should say tonight. You know what she told me? She said, honey, whatever you do, don't try to be too charming or too witty or too intellectual. You know, don't try to be anything you're not. I appreciate that. Just like all of you, I have watched Tiffany and Jen's relationship grow and blossom. It has been inspiring to watch, really. I mean, who would have thought that Jen would ever grow to love those dogs and their incredible vet bills the way she does?
Yeah.
Talk about being all in. Wow. And how about Tiffany? She's gone from not caring what anybody thinks to really only caring what Jen thinks. It really has been quite the transformation.
It's very true.
In all seriousness, it has been a great journey for these two. I have known Tiffany a lot longer than Jen and have watched her mature into the woman she is today. It took a lot of soul searching and more than a few questionable decisions along the way, but I've watched as she has figured out what she wanted to do in life.
The train's coming.
It is.
Pursued it with gusto. And eventually achieved everything she set out to do. She worked tirelessly to establish and maintain her independence. And then Jen came along. No big deal, we all thought at first. But you could tell in Tiffany's voice that her heart was beating out of her chest when she started talking about this woman she started to hang out with. Okay, Tiffany.
Okay, Russ.
Don't be too quick to call it what it is. Tiffany still had her guard up, but I think that deep down she knew what was happening. As time went on, we all wondered if this new love would last.
Sure. Yeah.
But then we all watched as Tiffany softened a bit and allowed herself to open up to the possibility of truly falling in love. She began to change and dedicate herself to the success of their relationship. I think we'd all agree that was a first. And even though I didn't know Jen before she met Tiffany, I'm sure there was an equal amount of opening up on her part too.
True story.
Yes.
That's what happens when we find the person we want to spend the rest of our lives with. They become more like us. We become more like them. But we both still maintain our own uniqueness. It's a fallacy, I think, to say that in marriage, two become one. In my estimation, two really becomes three. Simply put, the couple is greater than the sum of the parts. In preparation for today, I asked Jen and Tiffany to each sum up their relationship in just one word. Would you be surprised to know that they both picked the same word? Awesome, right? Talk about being in sync. The word they both picked was adventurous. How great is that? That's awesome. Not only does it speak to the adventure that they have been on as they fell in love and began building a life together,
it's never gonna end.
But it is a perfect word to describe marriage, I think. Marriage truly is the adventure of a lifetime.
Yes, it is.
Like any adventure, it has its good days and bad, its peaks and valleys, its twists and turns. But it also brings immeasurable joy and happiness along the way. My wife and I were told something when we got married that we still remember and share with other couples to this day. Marriage makes life half as hard and twice as fun. Marriage is a partnership. It requires teamwork, trusting one another, helping each other to navigate life's twists and turns together as a team. Whether it's something menial like running errands or stopping by the store on the way home, or it's dealing with a more serious challenge in life, having that teammate, having your partner by your side, makes life so much easier than going it alone. And life is at least twice as fun when you get to share it with someone you love. There are some who characterize married life as unexciting, They use phrases like settling down, indicative of a static, unchanging, boring future. But that couldn't be farther from the truth. Life, by its very nature, is full of excitement, and married life is no different. There are countless adventures yet to be had and memories yet to be made. And isn't the benefit obvious? You get to do all of these things with a loving partner by your side. Jen and Tiffany, as you continue this adventure together, embrace all that life throws your way. Relish opportunities to spend time with one another, learn from one another, and embrace one another. Accept your mistakes and find areas of compromise when you disagree, or just listen to Jen. Sow the seeds of trust and respect today and carefully tend to your relationship, and you'll reap the benefits for decades to come. Remember to lean on each other. Always keep your spouse at the center of your heart and be ever ready to provide them the support they need. Life often presents unexpected challenges, like a train, but these obstacles will be no match for the strength of your bond. If you can believe it, the love that you share today, as strong as it already is, will only continue to grow and flourish over time. This phenomenon is one of the greatest gifts life has to offer. Cherish it. And look around. Everyone here shares in your happiness. Everyone here supports your life together. Everyone here will be there for you if and when you need them. You are surrounded by people who love you and are thrilled you found each other. We all look forward to your future together. I'm confident that you'll find that life truly is half as hard and twice as fun together. Thank you for indulging me. Let's get this show on the road, shall we? Yeah? We ready?
Yep.
All right. Jennifer and Tiffany.
That's us.
Yes. Mm-hmm. The covenant you are about to make with each other is meant to be beautiful and sacred expression of your love for each other.
You all right?
As you pledge your vows and commit your lives to one another, we ask that you do so in all seriousness, yet with a deep sense of joy and with deep conviction that you are committing yourselves to a dynamic relationship of trust, mutual support, and unconditional love. Jennifer and Tiffany, these are the hands of your best friend, strong and full of love for you. These are the hands that will love you and cherish you through the years, and with the slightest touch, will comfort you like no other. These are the hands that will give you strength when you need it, support and encouragement to pursue your dreams, and comfort in difficult times. And lastly, these are the hands that even years from now will still be reaching for yours, still giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just one touch.
Six times six.
Tiffany.
Sir.
Do you take Jennifer to be your wife? Do you promise to love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Jennifer.
Yes.
Do you take Tiffany to be your wife? Do you promise to love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Friends and family, you occupy an important place in Jennifer and Tiffany's lives. You have sustained them in the past with your thoughts and prayers. Now that their life is entering a new phase, your role will be different, but not diminished. And so on this wedding day, this their wedding day, I ask you to remain steadfast in your support of them in times of trouble, and generous in your joy when they experience success and happiness. Do you give them your blessing now as they enter into this marriage? And do you promise in the days and years ahead to give them your deepest love understanding, and support during both good times and bad.
Yeah.
Boom, drop the mic.
Now that you have declared your intentions, I invite you to share your vows with one another. Tiffany, repeat to Jennifer after me. In the presence of God.
In the presence of God.
I, Tiffany, take you, Jennifer.
I, Tiffany, take you, Jennifer.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
Good job. You're welcome.
Jennifer, repeat to Tiffany after me, please. In the presence of God.
In the presence of God.
I, Jennifer, take you, Tiffany.
I, Jennifer, take you, Tiffany.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer and poorer.
7 times 7.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
Jennifer, I give you this ring.
Jennifer, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
With all that I am.
With all that I am.
And with all that I have.
And with all that I have.
I will honor you.
I will honor you.
And I will love you forever.
And I will love you forever.
Tiffany, I give you this ring.
Tiffany, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
Symbol of my vow.
With all that I am.
With all that I am.
And with all that I have.
All that I have.
I will honor you.
I will honor you.
And I will love you forever.
And I will love you forever.
Jennifer, Tiffany, by the powers vested in me by the state of Georgia, I now declare that you are hereby married.
Boom.
Ladies, you may now kiss your wife.
Woo! 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 Are you ready to?
Ladies and gentlemen.
I'll take it.
Okay.
It is my distinct privilege for the first time anywhere to present to you Jennifer and Tiffany Cribbs.
Woo woo!
Wait. Jennifer, Tiffany. But you're going to exit this wonderful ceremony to that song?
No, we're not.
No. We got to change this up a little bit.
You ready?
This was never the way. That's how you do it.
My intention.
I got so get on your feet for our newly wed, the new Cribbs family, Jennifer and Tiffany.
It's not what I'm used to. Just wanna try you on.
But Tiffany decided to follow her own schedule. We noticed that she missed a few sessions, and as we like to say, I drew the short straw. And it was decided I would be the one to give her a lecture about orientation being mandatory and that there was a lot to learn and blah, blah, blah.
Blah, blah, blah.
Blah, blah, blah. Her response was less than warm. I immediately put her on the sure to be trouble list. And thankfully for her, I didn't find out until years later that she had a few choice words for me after I walked away. Our paths crossed again a few months later, and this time was different. It was small, but I detected a small crack in the armor that gave me the chance to get to know her, and our unlikely friendship began to grow. Don't worry, to the rest of the world, I continued to refer to her as Compassionate Cribbs. I could tell you all kinds of stories about her college days, but I don't want to give Addison any ideas. I still remember the day when she decided she didn't want to work at Papa John's for the rest of her life. She decided she was going to be a police officer. Woo! Woo-hoo! As I told her a million times, it's her world, I just live in it. So I dropped her off at the county office for an interview, and just a few months later, after going through Academy Hell, I watched her walk across the stage and earn her badge. Now she could arrest people.
Absolutely.
She persevered through a lot over the years, and I couldn't be more thankful that she's allowed me to take this journey with her. Little does she know, I've been writing a book. We're going to be millionaires.
Which island are we buying?
One day I remember her telling me she met a new friend at work. They were workout buddies and were running up Stone Mountain. Now, the only time that Tiffany ran past was out of necessity, so something didn't seem quite right, but I went with it. We talked about this new friend more and more, and needless to say, I wasn't surprised that they were going to go out on a date.
Hanging out.
They were hanging out. It was all downhill from there. I met Jen for the first time actually in Savannah. Tiffany and I had just come from our yearly Bestie Beach trip, where I learned that Rikens had actually smashed through Tiffany's armor and captured Tiffany's heart. They had so much in common and make a great team. And P.S., don't try to take on either in a game of Disney trivia. I've enjoyed so much getting to know Jen over the past few years. She is truly, truly beautiful inside and out. And she puts up with Tiffany, so she really must be a saint. They have a true partnership that will truly make life half as hard and twice as much fun. I've watched their love bloom and grow and look forward to many more years of adventures with you both. Here's to many more years of laughter, love, and living life to the fullest. Congratulations. We all love you very much. Don't forget, happy wife.
Happy life.
Hello, everyone. As the big sister, I am fiercely protective of Jen. I would do anything for her, and she is one of the most important people in my life. Over the years, we have laughed, cried, and had so many amazing memories together. I am truly blessed to have someone like her in my life. Since I am so protective of her, you can imagine how skeptical of Tiffany was of when Jen first told me about her. Was she good enough for my sister? I soon learned that Tiffany is just as amazing as Jen. She cherishes her and would do anything to see her smile. They complement each other in the most perfect way. They are two twin souls that were destined to find each other. I could not be happier for them. So raise your glass and toast a happy couple.
Yeah. Hi, as many of you know, Hi, as many of you know, my name is Allison. If you did not know that, well, now you do. Tiffany has known me my whole life, all 10 years of it. Tiffany has seen all the ups and downs of my life. She was even there when I took my first steps. She was also there that one time when I, I'll save that story for another time. To me, Tiffany is like family. She's encouraging, funny, and considerate. As for Jen, I have not known her as long as Tiffany, but I know she is supportive, caring, and generous. Now that I describe the way I see them both, I have to say the first time I saw Tiffany and Jen together, I saw a very strong connection between them. I knew they would be together for a very long time. I love you, Tiffany and Jen. Thanks for everything. I cannot wait for all the travels and future memories of you two together.
I really didn't know how to start this tonight because Jennifer said, can you give a speech tonight? I am not good at speeches and I don't like good speeches. But I will start this way. Once more, 16 years ago, there was a girl born in this country by the name of Jennifer. When we were in the delivery room, she appeared and the nurse said, what are you going to name her, Dad? And Dad, being a good dad, went, and my dear wife said, Jennifer Ellis! And lo and behold, we have Jennifer Ellis. As years progressed, she got older. I found out that when she was growing up, and I had to take care of her, that she loved to go on a rocker swing. And she loved James Bond on TV. Every time I put her to tape of James Bond to get her relaxed to go to sleep, she would rock. She would go to sleep, and Dad would be happy. As years progressed, she kept on going to school. She went to high school, Northview. And then all of a sudden, 2000 came, and she graduated. Needless to say, we didn't know what college she was going to go to. And at that time, she says, hey, Dad, I'm just going to go to junior college for 2 years and give it up. I said, well, whatever you want to do, it's your life. Go ahead and do it. Well, the 2 years passed. Then she came home one day and she said, Sorry, Stan. I'm going to Michigan State University.
Woohoo!
Go Green?
Still love her.
Why?
Well, she went to Michigan State. She received a degree in police science. And then decided, Dad, I'm going to go to Florida. And I said, holy smokes. She just graduated from college, and now she wants to go to Florida. She went to Florida, joined Sanford Police Department as a dispatcher. Then apparently she wanted more travels, and then she decided to come to Atlanta. That's where all you folks came into play. She went to Atlanta, worked in a bar, an Irish bar, matter of fact. And then in the meantime, she decided to go to Georgia Tech. Georgia Tech decided to send her to Police Academy. And now she is a full-fledged officer with Georgia Tech. So none of us could have cried. She followed Dad's footsteps, which made me very, very happy. And in the meantime, she decided to take forensic science. I said, what is God is going on? This girl wants to go to school for the rest of her life. But she did. She got her courses, she graduated, and now she's working for two departments, Lawrenceville PD and Georgia Tech University, and apparently having a good time. In the meantime, someplace along the line, there was another woman that came into her life. One day, when we were there, myself and my wife, this was, I think, last year. And of course, we met Tiffany going on and on in the years that we've been there. We took a ride and went to the store. And Tiffany looked at me and said, Mr. Rikens, I have something to ask you. And I said, what do you want to ask you? Go ahead. She said, can I marry your daughter? I looked at her and I said, hey, whatever blows your bubble, go ahead and do it. I said, you know, you make her happy. She's always fussing about you. She's always happy. She's always smiling. And she is just a great smile on her every time Tiffany is around her. And lo and behold, today came. And they came together. Bless you.
Okay.
Hang on, we got to do some calculus. My sister-in-law Agnes has helped me on this one.
Thank you, Agnes.
God bless you both. May you have a long and happy marriage. Don't mind it. It felt so wrong. It felt so right. Don't mean I'm in love tonight.
Soft skin, red lips, so kissable.